long time no see, I know, but I'm still here. The last video I posted in German is about like me doing like preparations for this time now, for potential like lockdown here in Thailand, or yeah, what to do and how to also cope with loneliness. Because to just give you like a brief summary, I'm still in Thailand. Most of my close friends have left now, which gives me a strange feeling, and additionally to me feeling homesick for the past months actually, and seeing the situation in Germany, and additionally being a super emotional and sensitive person, makes me think a lot if I should go home or stay here or what to do. And additionally, I lost 3 jobs because of the crisis. So yeah, income wise it looks shit to be honest. So if you want to learn German or English, or like need somebody for your kids to help them with their English homework or German homework, I'm available. Just drop me a message, or drop me a comment, or drop me a message here. Just saying. We can talk further about this then. Yeah, so I feel... We have this expression in German, and I forgot how it's in English, but it's like... Basically, literally translated would be world pain. So I don't want to complain. So I'm not panicked. I'm not panicking. I just feel for all the people affected. And anyway, I know I haven't been uploading frequently, but I want to use this and my platform too, because I personally feel lonely, because now, like as I said, most of my good friends have left, all my friends who are my neighbors have left, so, and I'm also now trying to not go out that much or at all, like only if it's like necessary to buy stuff or something. And I have a problem with loneliness or isolation, in that sense that I'm struggling with not depression but depressive moods, and I like to be by myself, I like to be on my own and spend time with myself, but I do also need other people and human contacts, especially because for years I've been a freelancer and working at home by myself. So for me, my only time to socialize was in the evenings, to go out with people to restaurants and bars mostly. And now this is not possible anymore. It would be stupid to do it, or like unsolidarity-ish, you know what I mean? So I thought that if it's a win-win situation, I can talk with you, even though like right now it's just me looking at my camera, but I'm no, like I have you in my mind when I'm talking, and you can watch me and we can have a conversation. At least I talk to you and then you can talk back to me in the comment section. So so both of us won't, hopefully we'll feel less lonely. Alright, yeah, that was a long summary. So what I'm gonna do today is, I already made coffee. I was already active on Instagram. Follow me on Instagram. Here is my name. Now I will wash my clothes because I do hand washing. And from the coffee, because I'm using a French press, so I'm using the rest of the coffee as a peeling. Homemade peeling, and it's amazing. So I just take the coffee, I mix it with a little bit of water and sugar, and use it as a body scrub, and it's working so well. My skin is so smooth. I'm not using any soap after, just the peeling, and I smell like coffee the whole day, which is amazing. And then, yeah, I'm gonna answer the comments from my last video, and I'm looking for jobs. And then I will talk with you about like a hopefully quick flare up update and how I feel without taking medication for MS for 1.5 years. And tonight I'm gonna make hot dogs. I haven't made hot dogs in I don't know how long. So yeah, I got all my utensils for this, all my ingredients for this. I'm gonna show you how I'm gonna make it, and then I shut up because it's already 10 minutes and I don't want to make a movie out of this video. So let's get shit done. Alright, I wanted to update. Jesus Christ. I just filmed the German part and I just can't talk. I can't talk in German, I can't talk in English. Let's see how this goes, but yeah. So, I wanted to update you on the relapse, the flare up. It's been 3 months now since I uploaded my last video about that, and that was the video from Hanoi. And because I was supposed to be there for 5 days, but because of some visa issues, I will not go deeper into that though, I had to extend my stay, and I had to stay, I think, 6 days longer and figure that out. And that was a pretty emotional time and a financially hard time as well. So I was super afraid that because of those factors my relapse might take longer or get worse, but luckily that didn't happen. It's so weird. So I still had some problems with my eyes, the optic neuritis, but within this week, the 6 days I had to stay longer, it got better. I'm so surprised. Also, I can't really divide or tell if the symptoms I had were still from the flare-up or the stress, but magically it became better day by day. I remember on Christmas, well, I celebrate, or the Germans celebrate Christmas already in the evening of the 24th. That was 5 days after I came back to Thailand. I remember going to the supermarket and cooking a very nice Christmassy dinner for myself and feeling well physically. So I'm really surprised, and I decided on the first week I was in Hanoi that if it doesn't get better, I will actually go to the doctor in Thailand and ask him what I could do. I don't think I would have taken cortisone or steroids, but it's hard to tell, right? Because yeah, I didn't end up going to the doctor, right? Because when I came back to Vietnam, I had to figure out
the other situation. So
I'm really, really amazed and impressed by my body that it was able to handle everything at once so well. So I'm lacking words to describe how impressed I am and how thankful I am to my body for recovering so fast and under conditions like the ones I was in. Now I would like to end this video to prevent it from ending up too long. I will show you a recipe. I believe it's like a German, maybe Austrian recipe. I cooked it last night for the first time and it was so yummy. So it's basically mushroom ham cheese pasta and it was amazing. And I would like to know from you your favorite recipes. And if you cooked something new or exotic or something you've never cooked before while you're in quarantine right now, because I believe the most of you are in quarantine or self-isolation or however you call it, or stay at home, because we all should right now. And if you're comfortable to share where you're at in the world right now and how the situation is for you, leave me a comment down below. I only go out to buy food or water or like essentials, so I'm actually kind of busy. I have a lot of projects or things planned, and I'm trying to get back into yoga, but yeah, I always fail. So if you have tips how to continue doing yoga or be motivated to do sport, or what YouTubers you're watching or videos you're watching to do sport, yeah, also leave me a comment down below. I would be very happy about that. And yeah, as I said, in the next video I'm going to tell you how it feels for me to not take medication for 1.5 years now. And I will hopefully see you next time. Thank you for still sticking around. Thank you for still watching me, even though I don't upload frequently or kind of at all this year. thank you. I hope you're safe. I hope you're as healthy as possible and sending lots of love to wherever you are in this world. Safe. Bye-bye.